In this video, we're going to talk about a quick strategy for Facebook advertising for an e-com jewelry store. And this is a response to a comment that we got on the channel from Jeff DeVore. Hey guys, welcome to Marketing Hustle. My name is Zarin Sidhu, and on this channel, we simplify digital marketing so that you can accelerate your business growth. So in today's video, we have a question that came to us from Jeff DeVore, and it reads, "Hi, I'm running a new jewelry shop online, and I'm also new to Facebook ads. I have a Facebook page and a website. I've been struggling with conversion ads, and I wanted to aim for website purchases, but I only have 8 records of it on my Pixel. What could I do to make it perform better, or should I aim for a different goal? I'm also on a low budget as of now. Thanks and hope to hear from you soon." Well, Jeff, that is an ambitious goal, selling jewelry online on a low budget, but it's not impossible. So what I want to do is I want to give you a quick strategy that I think could help you out. So when you're often starting out, you probably don't have enough data on existing clients to be able to build a lookalike from previous purchasers. So I think what you can do is you can actually keep a conversion campaign. Now you don't have a lot of, it doesn't sound like you have a lot of purchases, so it's going to be hard for the Pixel to optimize for the right audience. But here's something you could do. You could actually, instead of optimizing for sales, you can optimize for a lower intent objective that still has some level of intent. The sale is the last part of the journey, right? But before that, somebody has to initiate checkout, someone has to add the product to the cart, and someone actually has to go to a product page and look at a product. So you could even start optimizing for view content just to maximize for an audience that's willing to actually look at your product pages. And what you can do is, you know, maybe run that for a week or two, depending on how much money you're spending, just to make sure you have enough traffic. I would try to aim to get at least 500 people to the website after the Pixel's there. And then what you can do is you can actually build a custom audience of the top 25% of people who have spent the most time on the site. Now, oftentimes people who spend more time on your website have a higher intent. So this could be a good way to go from this cold audience that you're targeting probably through interest and behavior. And now, instead of spending all your money on them, you can push that audience for a period of time to your website, but then use that to then isolate who are the people that are spending the most amount of time on your e-com jewelry shop. Now you can take that audience. It's probably not going to be that big, but the goal is to get at least 100 people in the market that you're advertising in. So for example, I'm in the United States. So my goal would be to get at least 100 people in that top 25% audience, ideally more, of course. And then I would build a lookalike audience off of that. A lookalike audience, 1%. So now you can start to shift away from the interest and behavior targeting, which, you know, to be honest, that's going to require money and a lot of effort for you to test different audience groups to figure out what the key audience is. So if you're on a limited budget and you need to quickly figure out, you know, what's an audience you could go after, it might not be your long-term end-all be-all strategy, but at least in the short term, being able to go from these broad interest and behavior targeting to then saying, all right, this audience is distinctively caring a little bit more about my products, and then scaling that with a lookalike, that could be an approach that can be quite beneficial. Also, when you do scale out and build this top 25% audience and then create a lookalike off of it, now when you go to run your campaign, you obviously want to do a conversion optimized campaign. But again, depending on performance, you might want to consider pivoting between this end objective of sales to something, you know, before that step, whether it's initiate checkout or add it to cart. Now, how do you determine that? Well, the Facebook Pixel, when it goes through the learning phase, requires 50 conversions in about under 7 days to understand who your key audience is and to exit the learning phase, which helps the algorithm understand who is actually the target audience. So my advice would be, if you cannot get at least 50 conversions in your audience in a week, whether that's because your performance is not there, or maybe you don't have the budget needed to actually drive those amount of conversions. If you start seeing limited delivery or inconsistent performance, then in that situation, I would recommend for you to maybe test doing an add to cart optimization instead of sales, which will drive a quality audience to your website and will give you a better chance to get 50 conversions within that 7-day period so that the Pixel could properly optimize. This would be one way I would prospect. Also, retargeting. You don't want to forget about that. Most sales, and I actually focus right now with jewelry e-com clients, and most of our sales come from the retargeting audience. So we spent a lot of effort doing upper funnel, you know, reach and traffic campaigns, building a sizable audience pool. And then we now focus conversion tactics to maximize against our retargeting pools. And that's, you know, our bread and butter. So you also want to consider retargeting as well. Now, from a creative ad unit perspective, what I would say is the ads formats that you probably want to lean into are collection units and carousels. These are great units to showcase product and really elevate them. The collection unit in particular, because you can actually show a lifestyle image or video and then on the bottom have actual products. And that tends to work really, really well, especially on Instagram because it's such a visually driven platform and it aligns itself very well with jewelry because there's a lot of influencers and a lot of visually aesthetic content on the platform. So you want to have a prospecting approach, which I already shared with you. And then you also want to retarget that audience so that you can maximize that performance. But you also want to be careful what ad formats you're using in order to maximize the performance of your campaigns. Me personally, when I see a collection ad unit with a video or an image that's showing me, you know, how the product looks on a person, that draws me in. And then now I want to see product focused photography. So hopefully when I go to the website, I can get that experience of both, or at least the ad unit having that lifestyle feeling in the ad can help me visualize. So then when I go to the website, I already know I'm interested in the product. Anyways, that is a quick strategy of how I would approach Facebook ads for an e-com jewelry shop if you're trying to improve the performance of your campaigns. Hey guys, thanks so much for tuning in once again to Marketing Hustle, where we simplify marketing so that you can accelerate your business growth. And if you like this video, smash that like button and subscribe if you learned something new, or if you just learned something you already knew and it just refreshed your memory. Also, if you have any specific questions about strategies or tactics, drop me a comment below. And if you're lucky and enough people like it and it's relevant, I'm gonna make a response video. So, see you in the next video. Peace.